Welcome back to Alana Media. Today we're talking all about how to build a social media strategy for the holidays. And now I'm gonna create a separate video on how to create an evergreen social media strategy, meaning a social media strategy that you can use any time of the year. But today we're gonna be focusing on a social media strategy during the holidays. So this will be a shorter term strategy that should ultimately tie into your overall strategy and your overall business goals. But without further ado, let's get started. The very first thing you want to do when you sit down to build your social media strategy for the holidays, whether you're a business owner creating this yourself or if you're a social media manager creating these for your clients, is that you want to get very specific on the goals you're trying to achieve during this holiday season. Whatever the time period is you're building your social media strategy for, you need to get very specific on the goals you are trying to achieve. The best way to do this, and how I like to do it, is create SMART goals. So you don't just want to say, I want to get more sales. That is not a goal that you will be able to work towards because it's not specific enough. So your SMART goals are specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time bound. If you are a business owner and you sell notebooks, you want to say, I want to sell this many notebooks by this time period at this price. So you want to be very specific on your goals. And you also want to be reasonable. The second letter in SMART, A, you want these goals to be achievable. The best way to do that is to look at your sales from holiday last year and see what you did and see how you can improve those sales. So you don't want to say, I want to sell 100,000 notebooks if last year during the holidays you only sold 5,000. That's just not achievable and it's not going to set you up for success and you're going to get disappointed. So that is your very first step in creating a holiday social media strategy. Your next step is to get specific on what you are selling. Are you having any Black Friday sales or holiday sales, or do you have any new holiday items? If you are, you need to make sure that yourself or your social media manager knows exactly what these are, what is included in the sale, when is the sale, when does it start, when does it end, and all of the fun nitty-gritty details of all your holiday content and sales. Once you get very clear on what your goals are and what items or services you're selling during the holidays, you can start actually planning your content. So like I said, you want this holiday strategy to tie into your overall strategy. So the next thing that you want to do is you want to go ahead and take a look at what type of content has been performing really well for you over the past 3 months. So go ahead, this is when you have to look at your analytics. What type of reels are doing really well for you? Are they talking videos? Are they trending audios? Are they B-roll with on-screen text? Or are graphics doing better for you? Or even static posts? Go ahead, take a look at what type of content is performing really well for you. That way you can transition your holiday content to these types of content that is already performing really well, so you know you're going to see the results that you want. Once you've taken a look at what type of content has done well and what type of content you can recreate, you can move on to auditing your account. You want to take a look at your pin posts and your bio and the links that are in your bio. If you're having a specific sale, you need a specific code or anything like that, you want to make sure you change the link in your bio to be where you want people to land on your website or on a booking page or anything like that. It's also a great idea to create a highlight, a story highlight on your Instagram about your sale, whether that's graphics, including the details of the sale or you talking about it. You definitely want to include that. And adding a pin post to your profile about the sale or some of your holiday items is a great idea as well, because when people first see one of your posts and they head over to your account, that's the first thing that they're going to notice. So you want to make sure your holiday items or your sale is front and center and easy for people to see right away when they click over to your profile. After you have all of those fun things in place, you can start building out your content calendar. And how far out you build your content calendar is going to depend on a couple factors. You can either, one, plan your content calendar topics and content pillars, and I'll make a whole other video about content pillars, but to break it down, content pillars are 3 to 5 topics that have to do with your business that you consistently post about. Like I said, you can either create your content calendar where you just have the content topics and the pillars outlined, mind, and then you go ahead and create the content for that week the day of. If you have more time to plan or you're going to take more time off, I recommend creating all of that content ahead of time. So once you plan out all the content topics and the pillars, you're going to want to go in and actually create that content. And you want to alternate between your content pillars and also the content categories. So the content categories are educational content, inspirational content, entertaining content, and promotion content. Since it is the holidays, you're most likely running a sale or trying to promote more holiday content. The promotion is going to be a little bit more heavy, but you definitely want to make sure it's not in your face. And a big tip when you are creating your holiday content, you want to make sure it is still on brand. So if your brand colors are not red and green, don't use a lot of red and green because you still want people to recognize your brand when they see your content. Of course, you can make it a little bit more holiday by wearing different things in your content, wearing different colors, adding your holiday items to the pictures, but don't think you have to completely rebrand just because it's Christmas. And my biggest tip when you are creating your holiday strategy is to schedule things ahead of time, especially during the week of Christmas, the week of Thanksgiving, and the week of New Year's. If you're gonna step away from your phone, you can still have posts going out by scheduling. You can schedule posts directly in Instagram and Facebook, so you don't even need to pay for a separate platform unless you're a social media manager and you're probably managing a lot of accounts, so it's easier to pay for another scheduling platform like Later or Metricool. And that is really how you build a social media strategy during the holidays. It's definitely about planning ahead, thinking ahead, scheduling the content when you know you're not gonna be able to be by your phone all the time. During the holidays, just remember, bigger companies are spending a ton of money on social media ads, so your reach may go down a little bit unless you're running ads as well, but this is totally okay and not something to freak out about. This is definitely a great time to focus on engagement and engage with your audience and other brands and local businesses so you don't fall away to the wayside. So if you can be on your phone and you're not taking a ton of time off of your business, definitely still be active in your stories, sell in your stories, use link stickers, and directly sell to your audience. But don't be discouraged if your analytics go a little bit in the red this time of year just because bigger businesses are spending a lot of money on ads. And with this whole social media strategy, it is 100% okay to not post on Thanksgiving, to not post on Christmas Day, and to not post on New Year's. If you're just gonna post and ghost, meaning post something, schedule it, and then not go on the app all day and not reply to any comments or anything, it's probably a good idea to just not post at all. A lot of people are gonna be spending time with their families on the actual holidays and most likely will not be on their phone that much. So it's definitely okay to take time off during the holidays. So I wanted to say that so you don't take away from this video that you need to be posting every single day throughout the holidays, because that is definitely not true. You don't even need to be posting 5 times a week. 3 times a week is definitely enough to keep your brand going, and then of course as many days as you can in your stories Monday through Friday. If you have any questions about how to build your holiday social media strategy, please leave them in the comments or send me a DM on Instagram. I'll be sure to answer them as soon as I can. And I am hosting a free 12-day social media challenge to help you keep your sanity on social media during the holidays. For 12 days leading up to December, I will be sending you an email to your inbox every day with a challenge and a tip to keep your sanity on social media during the holidays, because I know it is a super busy time and can be a super stressful time for people, but it is still important that you're marketing your business and putting time into it so you end the year on a good note. So if you would like to sign up for that challenge, again, it's totally free. The link is in the description of this video. And thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something new, and I'll see you next time.